the presentation of green boats. Evaldas Narušis will present the result of the Elmar project demo boat that have been done during this 4 years that project was running. Please, Evaldas.
Hello, everyone. Okay, I'll share my screen. Okay. Okay. Everyone is. Do you see my screen?
Yes, we do, Evelyn.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let me present you our project and its results. So something like 5 years ago, we bought some old rescue boat. It was in very poor condition, the hull, and we decided to retrofit it to electric 12 passenger boat. Okay, and some short overview of our electric design of electric components. So we took small brushless motor. It says it's up to 30 kilowatts, but we didn't test it yet. But currently we know that our vessel is quite happy with 10 kilowatts of power. Yeah, so, but it can be even forced up to 30 kilowatts, but we don't need that power. We built the battery from the Tesla battery modules. In total, now it's theoretically it's 60 kilowatt hour of power, and the charging capacity is only charger is limiting us. We have 3.3 kilowatts of charging power. It takes about 16 hours to charge fully our battery. And there's some custom made battery management and automation systems. Okay. So very first steps was to do 3D scan of the hull. Here you can see the raw data. Then was modeled the through that scanned points was the hull modeled with Delft chip software. And then on that model, the all existing planes was designed. And later, from that stage, the design was started. So we designed a small cabin, the open deck with the steering wheel and console. Yeah. Okay, and simultaneously the whole renovation was started. It was in quite poor shape. So we fixed the sides of the vessel because it was very cracked. And later we turned it keel towards the up and did tiny renovations. The bottom of the hull was not in so really bad condition. We did sand, many sanding. You can see the some spots where the we have the filler, and this is the hole. So it means that it was not really straight and nice from its fabric, because rescue boat doesn't need to be very, very nice and really. Yeah, here you can see the big areas of filler covered. Yeah, and here you can see the cracks. All that cracks is, it's not the biggest ones, but all that cracks is fixed. The poor condition glass fiber was removed and covered with new one. After that, we cover it with primer and then with anti-fouling. And then we took back in normal position and continued to fix the sides and the edge and the sides. It took very long time, and we spent many man hours to do this. Next steps was to work with interior and exterior. Yeah, we cleaned and filled with filler. There was some cracks also inside, because the hole was on an open area left all the time, and it was full with water, so everywhere was cracks. And so we fixed that and then started to install wooden constructions, supports for cabin, for seats, for some space for storage. Everything is sealed and covered with epoxy resins, and so to make it durable for moisture and the water. Yeah, it's the bottom, preparing for the bottom. There is some image of deck, inside deck. Only preparing. This is some nice and easy technology, how to make the contour of existing part, and after you can put very nicely the outside works. There was many challenges because of the water, how to make the water go not inside the vessel as usual for that kind of vessels, but go direct outside. Yeah, here you can see the propeller shaft installation. There was also some challenge. This is the truss bearing installed. And we need to make some angle here, because the propeller shaft is straight and the motor won't fit there. So we installed some angle joint for the shaft. Yeah, here you still can see the pictures of truss bearing installation. It was done to very precisely to avoid any vibrations. Yeah, this is still the old propeller, bilge pump. Yeah, still installation. This is the motor. We choose it to use belt drive. It's silent and low maintenance. We are happy with it. Works very fine. The motor also, I think, has enough torque to spin the propeller, but we did some reduction, because theoretically it should be more effective. Yeah, we still don't have very much of the data, not yet collected, but the results is happening. The results is good for us, and we will continue to test the system. And here you can see the results of our short test on the water. Here you can see that the 6 kilowatts, the vessel is sailing even faster than its regular cruising speed. So I think that 5 knots is the very good speed, and with that speed we use only 2 kilowatts of power. It's not much. And here you can see the estimation. It's only theoretical, not tested yet, but I think it can be something close to that. Yeah, an estimated range. It's still only theoretical calculations. Okay, thank you very much. Maybe there are some questions.
So
about our project.
Thank you, Evaldas. It's very nice to see the electric system in the vessel, and the ship has the second life. By the way, I've just was. Day before yesterday, I was in the boating area also, and I saw also a boat very similar to yours in the poor state, staying on the ground upside down. And I said, "Yeah, that's the second one." really similar, but of course,
there is plenty of that kind of the boats.
Yes, but this 2 kilowatts that you say for the 5 knots, it's really very, very nice, because when you have a pleasure boat and you like to stay calm in somewhere on the water, enjoying the atmosphere, I believe that is quite good speed for such a purpose. And with the 2 kilowatts, you will have, I believe, the range quite that will be hours and hours. You can, I believe, a few days will be enough to to sail. But then even you said for the 60 kilowatt hours, you need 16 hours. That's from one side. It's for the each day usage, even could be enough when you use the boat 8 hours a day. Generally, then it's of course it's on the limit, but still it's quite good characteristics. And from another side, when you do not need to charge it each day, that is also quite a good. So please, anybody has the questions to Evaldas, because they've gone really good way to from the scratch till the final results. And last week there were demo tests of the boat. Can you share a bit of experience, Evaldas, maybe? How do you find the result? Are you satisfied?
We still need to do longer trips, but there is something to check and to improve. We need to know more about the cooling. Now we are using passive cooling, so no cooling at all. So we are still deciding, do we need to water cool the motor or not? So the drive is cool enough and the motor seems to be a little hot, but it's not that hot that it's danger for the motor. Next thing, we need to maybe to adjust the power for the motor. Sometimes if we get some growth on a propeller, some seaweeds or something like that, we lose the power. But in current stage, we are limited the power of the motor. Yeah, so maybe I need to increase the power to, in case you have some marine growth on the propeller, you just increase the power for the propeller and they will be blown away. Yeah, we need to improve the maneuverability for the vessel. It's quite tricky to turn around in a narrow channel. It's possible, but it's need good experience of the. Yeah, and still we need to do the one sailing from 100% of the battery to the zero. It's not done yet, and we'll see the final numbers how it is.
Mm-hmm.
But for general cruising, and I think it's okay. I calculate like 1 hour of charging, 1 hour of sailing. If you have the right infrastructure, you can triple the charging speed. So it means 20 minutes of charging, 1 hour of sailing.
So generally, it's quite okay, and you have still then the possibility to upgrade the charging when it will be necessary.
Yes.
But then remembering what Frank said, that for the batteries, the higher the temperature of the batteries, the less the life of the batteries. Is that the case for you, or the batteries stay cool?
No, in our setup, batteries is cool, and because of that big amount of the battery that we have, so the batteries don't feel any
heating,
big power charging or discharging, so they feel very good.
Okay. But then you said the maneuverability, is that the case for the boat thruster?
I think for improve of the rudder.
Ah. Mm-hmm.
I think that we need to do it more balanced rudder, make it longer the part that goes towards the propeller, because now if we turn the steering wheel to one side, there's still some area of the propeller there that it's making a forward thrust. So we need to
cover that,
close that area.
Yeah, close.
To as much as possible. So we took forward thrust and push it, make it to the side thrust. Usually that kind of vessels are quite steerable and maneuver enough without boat thruster.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And for the boat thruster, the draft it's not so big of that vessel, so I don't know.
Oh, there are some small boat thrusters that would help, I believe. Mm-hmm. I don't know, Dino maybe have the something to propose in this case. when you decide about it.
Some solution. Yeah. And maybe solar panels to charge faster.
Okay. Yeah, I believe you can maybe exchange some information in this regard. Okay, Evaldas, thank you very much.